Hello guys, this is Akari and today I will be showing you how to express lighting in your drawings. Well, before we get started, I'm just going to give you a quick class on the basics of lighting. Well, what we're going to do first is we are going to draw a ball and the sun, which is going to act as our light source in this case. Once we have that, I'm just going to go ahead and quickly sketch the light rays that our light source, the sun, is going to produce. This area right here, where the light rays are hitting our object, is what we call the highlights. And the area opposite to it, the area that's not hit by these light rays, is what we call the core shadow. Now, the next thing we have is the cast shadow. As you can see, I had a bit of trouble drawing it and I still didn't really get it right, but that's fine. Anyways, the cast shadow is the shadow that is, as its name says, cast by our object. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw the light rays again, except I'm going to draw them as they actually behave. What I mean to say is that light rays don't just stop when they hit an object. They bounce against it and against anything that is around them. What this does is create what we call the bounce light. The bounce light is the reflection of the environment into the shadows of our object due to the bouncing of the light rays. It may be a bit tricky to understand and even to explain, I'm not going to lie, but it's very easy to apply, so don't worry about it. Right now, what you're seeing on your screen is just a speed paint of me lining this quick sketch that I've made specially for this video. So once it's done, we will get right into the explanations. Now that my line art is done, it's time to fill in my base colors. As you can see, I've already gone ahead and done that. But I'm just going to quickly explain to you guys why I'm using such dark colors as my base. Well, you see, if I were to use lighter colors, like these, if I start doing highlights in such light colors, then it's going to look a little bit weird because there's not enough contrast within these colors. However, if I do the highlights here, you can clearly see how much more contrast I'm achieving by barely choosing a darker color palette. If you prefer to use lighter base colors, go ahead, do that. This is just my personal preference and my personal recommendation. Once that's out of the way, I'm going to go ahead and choose my light source. For this drawing, I want my light source to be right above my character, or maybe even a little bit in front of her. Now I'm going to create a new layer on top of my base colors, clip it and set it to overlay. I'm going to choose white and I'm going to start drawing in the highlights. But wait, how do I know where to put them? How do I know where to put the highlights? Well, lucky for you, I'm about to share with you a trick that I love to use when I'm doing dynamic lighting. Basically, you have to imagine yourself as a camera that's in the same place as your light source. Now, what do you see? Well, I see a head, and I see a nose, shoulders, I see breasts, maybe a little bit of tummy, some feet, the arms and hands, and there you go. Now I know that these areas are the ones that need to be highlighted. Now you might be thinking, well, that's a little bit hard for me. And I agree, it may be hard to visualize this perspective when you've never done it before. So here comes the special solution, exclusive to Clip Studio Paint. You're going to click in this arrow right here and you're going to open the menu. And you're going to search for 3D. Then you're going to scroll down until you find your 3D model. You're going to drag that into your canvas. And there you have it. Now you're going to pose your model like your drawing. This is a little bit tricky, I'm not going to lie. But you don't need to make it perfect. It's just to guide yourself a little bit. Now that this is done, we are going to come right here where it says Tool Property. And I'm going to scroll down until I see Light Source. If this isn't checked, then check it. And now, in order to simulate our light source, we're just going to drag this sphere right here. Since my light source is on top of my character's head, I'm going to drag it to the top and fix it. I think this is okay. Now you know exactly where the light hits. Okay guys, now it's time to polish and clean up the highlights that we drew previously. In the video, it shows how I start drawing highlights from zero without the guidance that we drew earlier. However, I was using it as a reference, but it just was in a different display, that's why it's not showing up in the screen right now. Anyways, now you only need to erase what you feel like and draw in whatever you feel missing. For example, I thought that a little bit of lighting on the leg would look nice and I just drew it. You can just take as many creative liberties as you want. Art is not objective, so you don't need to be afraid of making any mistakes. If you don't like how it looks like, you can just erase it and start again. After the highlights, it's time to draw in the shadows. The way I like to do it is to create a new layer, set it below the highlights layer, and set it to multiply. Then I like to choose a deep violet color in order to draw the darkest shadows. These will usually be located below the neck and in the back of the hair. Now it's time to add in the bounce light. Choose a cool color like baby blue and apply it softly in the darkest shadows. Depending on the intensity of the lighting that you used, this step will or will not be necessary. So it's totally up to you if you want to do this step or skip it. Now, the drawing is technically done, however, there's something that I want to show you guys. It's an effect that I call subtle inner glow. And it's very easy to do and I'm sure you already know how to do it. Still, I'm going to explain it. What you want to do is you want to select the highlights layer pressing Command or Control. And then click in the miniature in the layer. And then you're going to expand that selection as much as you want, since it depends on your canvas size. Then you're going to create a new layer below the highlights layer, and you're going to fill it in with an orange color. Now this looks crazy. So what we're going to do is we're going to select the highlights layer again, and we're going to erase it in this new layer. Okay, now we're going to filter and Gaussian blur, and we're going to blur it again as much or as little as you want. I think this is okay. So there you go. Now we're going to set this layer to overlay, for example. You can just play around with the different layer settings, honestly. So overlays right here. I'm going to lower the opacity and I think that looks really good. Now I'm going to play a little bit with the colors because I think that a pinkish shade will look really good in the hair. And honestly, I think that looks a lot better. Your drawing is done. Now you're free to add any other personal touches that you like to do. For example, I really like creating a new layer, set it to overlay, and with a soft airbrush, just change a little bit the hues. I like to do some orange in the skin, maybe some red to highlight the dress, and some blue for the hair. Now I lower the opacity. There you go. I want to add some pink, so I will do that. And ta-da! It's done! Now you know how to express different light settings in any drawing very easily. I hope that this tutorial was useful, and if it was, please be sure to like it and share it with your friends, since that would mean the world to me. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you again in another video or in another tutorial.